Former federal Liberal MP Pat Farmer is on a mission to win support for The Voice to Parliament. With the Prime Minister in his corner, the ultramarathon runner set off from Hobart, bound for Uluru. Mark Burrows has the story.
Any runners that are coming with me?
Pat Farmer, centre of attention now, but he's about to be a one-man show. Around Australia in 6 months, campaigning for a yes vote, letting his feet do the talking.
9, 8, 7.
The PM, his chief cheerleader.
Go!
There are mountains to climb, deserts to cross, but Hobart's waterfront a gentle stroll for what he's facing.
This is an exercise of unity. My footsteps are the thread that will weave together this magic tapestry that will take us on into the future.
Some Indigenous Tasmanians boycotted the event, believing The Voice will consolidate power in Canberra.
Nothing can be further from the truth. This is a voice to Canberra from Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, showing them respect.
After Tasmania, he'll head north from Perth, across the Top End, down the East Coast, Melbourne, Adelaide, Uluru. 80 kilometres a day, 14,500 in total. A few k's down the road, the start was still on his mind.
A kid that grew up in Granville, to have an audience like that.
Pat Farmer will be a man for all seasons, taking in a Tassie autumn. By mid-winter, he'll be in North Queensland and well into spring, finally, at Uluru. And by then, a date will have been set for the referendum.
Some extra incentive for Pat Farmer. The latest poll for Nine newspapers show the yes vote at 58%, no at 42%. But 1 in 5 voters, a big chunk, are undecided. The kid from Granville has a long, lonely road ahead. In Hobart, Mark Burrows, Nine News.